Never underestimate sleep. A recent study points to a link between sleep and dementia later in life. The Clayton Sleep Institute's Dr. Joe Ogile joins us live. Doctor,
good morning. John.
Yes. Hey, this study, this really worries me because we don't get enough sleep. And if this is true, my future and Randy's future looks bleak.
We're toast, Doc.
Explain this.
You know, John and Randy, I had to tell you, I thought of you both when the study came out. And
so, well, you were on vacation in Telluride, right?
Well, I was on vacation. I couldn't even sleep because I was so concerned. This study is really interesting for all of us. It hits us all where we live. It's a study that looked at sleep duration. It was looking at many things, but it was a long-term study, 25 years in the United Kingdom. They looked at 8,000 patients' sleep and had both subjective and objective measures of duration, and found that those who sleep 6 hours or less did have a significant increase in risk over time, even if you account for all other factors, cardiometabolic, diabetes, age, weight. Take all that out, the risk was still there for the people who slept 6 hours or less. And it was in mid-age, so 50s, 60s, and 70s. So it hits us where we live. It's a long-term study. There have been other studies showing some of these associations with pro and con, but those studies, by and large, were 10 years or less of observation. So this is a powerful study for us because it's so, the follow-up was so long, 25 years. You don't often get a study that follows a huge population of folks. They actually followed 10,000 people, but 8,000 of them were asleep.
So how old were they when they started having symptoms of dementia?
So by and large, when you read the data, the dementia symptoms began anywhere after their 70s, by and large. So some of these people started being followed when they were in their late 40s, early 50s, and developed the dementia 20 years or so later, by and large.
Why the heck didn't you do this study back when we were in our 40s?
Well, we asked them to start the study with you in mind, and it just took a while for of the data to come out. So it's a very interesting study. It helps us show some further encouragement to our neighbors and friends and viewers to work sleep as a habit. Because again, these are long-term habits.
7 hours.
There was some benefit to those who reverted to normal sleep. And so they define normal sleep at about 7 to 7.2 hours. This study did not show any increased risk for dementia for the long sleepers, those who sleep 8 or 9 hours or more. Now, that has been shown in other studies, so it remains to be seen whether that'll come out or not.
All right, nod and get some sleep.
I need some sleep.
Earthborn's going to do the same. Dr. Ogile,
we'll have some.
Thank you.
John, we'll have somebody call you both to make sure you go to sleep early tonight.
My wife's pretty good at that. Joe Ogile, thank you.